There's one, you know, where I like set up my entire bedroom set in a vacant lot so I'd have tall grass. I just invited people to get in bed with me in the afternoon. I mean, I was had my pajamas on and stuff.
Sit in a chair in the middle of the street with a bunny mask until someone actually came up and punched him in the face.
That wasn't planned, by the way. It can become dangerous at times.
I know a few artists that are willing to subject themselves to the physical rigors of Galen's performances.
The one individual said, well, the first time I met Galen, he was in a dog cage, and the other one said there were a couple of people. Well, when I met Galen, he was hanging on a cross.
Kind of this is why I love this man. So I actually wrote my first art reviews about Fort Gondo. I never, though, met Galen through these encounters because he was always sort of this mythological creature who was always so busy and moving around behind the scenes but not present. So it was a couple of years later, after I graduated and I was looking for things to do still in St. Louis, and I thought, oh, Galen would be great to contact because he's always doing something. And at the time he was running for alderman in this ward. And so he had me design his aldermanic campaign literature, and that's how we finally met.
Yeah, I think Jessica thought I was disabled or inebriated or under the influence or something.
I ended up talking to a mutual friend of both of ours afterward, and I said, you know, should I be aware of there being him having a condition or anything?
So anyway, part of the prenuptial agreement was for me